When our group first started with our Wicked Problem Project, we were all a little overwhelmed on all the options we could provide as a solution to our problem.
We have a platform where everything's housed online so that like students can access it no matter like if they're at school or if they're, you know, if they are gone for a week or two because they can't get to school.
Learning teacher, I'm doing this all day long, just using it. I don't know if you guys have ever used iReady or have heard of iReady, but it's they all have their individual logins and it tracks the data with like real-time feedback, which I know it's the frequent formative assessments and instant feedback was put on there, and it's something that solves it like right then and there.
I think this is kind of the problem then that they're talking about is all these things are available already, so we already can get the information online. So I'm wondering if the actual Wicked problem is making the kids, you know, engaged and not just clicking around or just watching a video or taking a quick assessment.
After much discussion, we focused on one main idea, project-based learning, and how online learning can help facilitate
project-based learning and then the differentiated learning, too.
I'm doing a lot of project-based right now. I'm piloting for Scholastic. Mm-hmm. And I'm realizing how engaged my students are. We're doing an online blog about a nature center nearby. But I was thinking of...
After deciding on our solution, we got down to business discussing research and evidence and how we can connect the GUE.
Students expect learning that matters, learning connected in timely ways to the real world, learning that engages their interest. So I think it has to do, like, using those online programs, but making it meaningful, but that's an awesome way to connect to, because obviously he wants us to use the G reading, so we could always connect and being like, well, we're more likely to remember stuff or use our memory when it's meaningful and connecting. So
yeah, the G reading where it says, like, I focus a lot on this in my paper, the circuit of reflective action, where, like, you need mentorship, so, like, you can't just put a student on the computer if they have no background knowledge and they still need, like, the teacher's mentorship. Like, they can use the computer, but they need a mentor in it.
When we were done discussing via Google Hangouts, we used a Google Doc to brainstorm and share resources we found with each other. We also communicated via email to divvy up tasks and to support each other to make sure we met all of our deadlines. We also wrote our paper in Google Docs so that we could edit and provide comments to each other.